when working with CSS or with anything for that matter, it's always a good idea to, at least from time to time, think outside of the box. And one of the fantastic resources on the web that will force you to think outside of the box in terms of CSS is CSS Battle, CSS Code Golfing Game. The goal of the game is to replicate a number of targets that the game provides with the least amount of CSS that you possibly can. And those targets are really creative and not something that you would do in your day-to-day work. They will actually force you to step outside of your CSS comfort zone. And while you do that, you will probably learn something new about CSS that's going to be really handy in your real-life projects as well. All right, let's jump into our first CSS battle. You're going to find CSS Battle at cssbattle.dev. Link is going to be in the description as always. And I'm going to jump straight into Battle 24, which is going to be offset this one. And I will replicate all this beautiful CSS art and hopefully we'll learn something along the way. I will start with this one, 143. Before we dig in, I want to make it clear that I will not focus on the gaming aspect or how to recreate this particular challenge with the fewest lines of code as possible. Instead, I will solve different challenges with different techniques so you can hopefully learn something new along the way. All right, let's start with the first battle. I'll remove the comment here. And for this battle, all we need to do is create this circle. And this seems like a really straightforward challenge. All we need to do is remove the margin from the body, increase the size of this particular object, and add border radius to this rectangle. So let's do that. First, I'll add a background to the body. There we go. We'll increase the size. This looks like it's 50% of the viewport, which is going to be 400 pixels. So my size should be 200 pixels. Let's see. This looks correct. But let's also remove margin on my body. All right. And let's add border radius, 50%. And let's see if this is correct. It appears to be. The last thing we need to do is we need to use actually color provided in this challenge, which is going to be this one. And if I check the div here, you're going to see that this should be exactly the target that we needed to replicate. So for this challenge, all we need to do is remove the margin from the body, change the colors, add body radius to the div that we're using, and that's pretty much it. So let's submit this and start with our next challenge. The next challenge is going to be 144. Long heart. The simplest way to solve this challenge would be to create a couple of elements and then position them absolutely so we get a shape like this one and then add border radius to the ends. But I will try to challenge myself and I'll try to solve this using CSS grid. So it seems to me like we need three columns and three rows. Let's start by removing the comment here and adding the background colors that we actually need. So on our body, we'll set background to this color. And our div is going to have this yellow color, precisely as necessary. The next step is to actually set up our grid, and we'll actually use body tag as a container for our div. Display grid. And here I will use grid template areas to set up my grid. And if you don't know how grid template areas work and why I should use them, then check out my video on grid template areas. Link is going to be on the screen and in the description. So here we will set grid template areas. And we will define structure exactly as we see on the picture. Our first row is going to be empty, so we will just add three dots here. Our second row is going to be this element right here, and then two empty elements. So let's call this an A element, two dots. And for our third row, let's extend our A element, and then let's add another one, which is going to be B, and then again an empty one, which is going to be this area right here. So next, we need to assign elements to areas we just created. And for that, we actually need more div elements here. Our first div is going to have class A. Second one is going to have class B. All right. And let's remove margin on our body as well. Margin zero. There we go. I will leave this div selector here because we want to have the same background on all our div elements. And I will add selector.a here. And we will assign it to the grid area A. There we go. And for our B element, we will assign it to grid area B. There you go. And this looks nothing like our structure set up here, AAB. And that is because we have defined width and height on our div element. So we'll remove this. And now immediately this looks much closer to what we're looking for. But of course, the sizing is not right. So let's address this. I'll set grid template column sizes. And this seems something like 50 or 75 pixels. Let's try 75 pixels. This is going to be double that, maybe 150 pixels. And last empty space should be as much as it needs to be. So I'll set it to one fraction unit. And This appears to be okay. And now we need to set group template rows. The first row is going to be this empty space right here, and we want to stretch it as much as it needs to stretch. I'll set it to one fraction unit. The second row is going to be this one right here, and this seems to me like 100 pixels. Let's try this. And the last one is going to be 75 pixels, exactly as was our first column. So let's see how this looks. And 100 pixels for our second row is not enough, so we need to increase that. So this should be 125. All right, this seems pretty much okay, but our second column is a little bit too big. So we actually also probably need 125 pixels here. This looks okay. So let's set border radius to this element here and this element here. So our A element is going to have top left and top right border. This is going to be dot A, border radius. Let's set it to 75 pixels, 75 pixels, 0, 0. This is okay. And for our B element, we want to set border radius on top right and bottom right. So this is going to be 0, 75, 75, and 0. Okay, we're almost done. All we need is this beautiful curve right here. And for that, we will create another element and position it exactly to this area right here, which is currently empty, but we will designate it as grid area C. Let's add another div with the class C. And let's assign it to grid area C. And we need to change the size of this. So let's change width to something like 50 pixels and height to something like 50 pixels. Now this element is positioned at the top left of this particular grid area, but we actually want to adjust this and position it to the bottom left. And to do that, we'll set align self to end because we want this to be at the block end. And justify self should be start exactly as it is by default, so we don't have to change this. So let me temporarily change this color to red so we can see what's happening. All right. So I want to create an element that has this yellow color and then another one exactly at the top that will overlap it and hide all areas that are not necessary, which is going to be everything except for this small little border here with the purple that we have for our background. And for that, I'm going to use a pseudo element. So we'll do dot C after we set content property to empty. Width is going to be 100%. Height is going to be 100% again, because we want size to be exactly the same as the parent element or this C element. And let's set background to blue so we can actually see it. Nothing is happening because we need to actually position it before. So position absolute, instant zero. And this is of course stretching over our entire body because we didn't set position relative on our actual C element that we want to have as a reference point. So we'll set position relative here. There we go. And now this after element is positioned exactly at the same place as our C element. So it's actually overlapping it. Next, I will set border radius to this element. And if you didn't understand exactly what I'm trying to do here, it's going to be really clear right now after I set this. So border radius is going to be 5 pixels, for example, and we'll adjust the layer if we need to. And now you see that our C element, or this red one, is coming true. So I'll remove this red background from this element. And now we have exactly the yellow we want, but we only want the border radius on bottom left. So all the other border radius will be set to 0, 0, 0, 0. This background needs to be the purple one, and that way we will actually mask entirety of the element that we don't want users to see. And there we go. Now this looks exactly as our target. So to recap this particular challenge, we actually created a grid system and used grid template areas to define exactly how we want our grid to look. And I will actually open developer tools now to show you exactly how this grid looks. So grid is defined right here on the body element of our iframe. And as you can see, we have this toggle grid here. I'll click it and I see exactly how we set up our grid. So our first row is going to take as much space as it needs to. Our second row is going to be 125 pixels and our third row is going to be 75 pixels. And for our columns, we're actually doing the opposite. We're setting the 75 for our first row, 125 for the second row, and third one is going to be one fraction unit or as much space as it's left over. We actually assigned three elements to areas that we created. Our first element is stretching two rows and one column. Second one is one column, which is going to be this one. And the last element that we've added, this beautiful little curve here, is set in this area C. I will close developer tools now. So we actually created two overlapping elements. The bottom element, or C element in our case, is gonna have a yellow background. And we positioned another element exactly of the same size on top of it. And we've added border radius to bottom left. So we have this yellow background from our bottom element coming through. And of course, this C after pseudo element has background color of purple, which means this is going to look exactly as our background. And that's how we actually recreated this particular target using CSS Grid. I'll submit my result here and we'll move on to our next challenge. The next challenge is Spotlight. And for this challenge, we're going to use CSS Flexbox instead of Grid. So I can show you how Flexbox works as well. I'll remove the comment here. I'll change the colors now. Our div is going to be this color. And our background, which will sit on our body tag, will have this pink color. There we go. And a little remove margin here and set display to flex. All right. And now we actually want to align this element to this edge. So we need to set justify content end. There we go. And now we need to tweak the sizing. And this looks like it's 150 or maybe 200 pixels. It is, this is correct. And to recreate the second element, I'll use pseudo element after. So I'll set div after. We need content here, empty string. And the sizing should be identical to div element. So we'll set width and height to 100%. And let's set background to purple so we can see if this actually is working. And of course we need position absolute along with the inset 0, and inset is shorthand for top, bottom, left and right properties. So that's what we're doing here. And of course we need position relative on our div element because we want to position this after pseudo element relatively to our parent element, to our div element. And now the sizing is exactly the same as before. So what we need to do here is we need to add a border radius and we need to rotate the element. So let's add border radius first. Border radius, 50%, 50%, 0, or rather 0, 0, 50%, because we want it to face the other way. Okay. And let's rotate this by 45 degrees. And rotate is actually a standalone property for transform rotate. And if you don't know how standalone properties for transform work, check out my video on individual transform properties. Link is going to be on the screen and in the description as always. And now we need to move this element to the position where it needs to be. And for that, we'll remove inset property and we'll set top and left properties. Top is going to be something like 100 pixels and left is going to be minus 100 pixels. Now this is too far, so we probably need something like 50 pixels instead. Let's try this. All right. This seems to be okay. All we need to do is remove this purple background, I'd rather change it to the white we have here. And there we go. Now this might look like it's a tiny bit off, but it should be good enough. To recap this challenge, we positioned this element using flexbox, justify content, and then we added another element, pseudo after element, and positioned it absolutely in relation to the div element, which is going to be this parent element, this box. And we rotated this element by 45 degrees, and set its top and left position exactly where it needs to be. And now that I'm talking about top and left, you should actually be using logical CSS properties and not properties like top, left, bottom, and right. This goes for margin, for positioning, for basically anything. And if you want to learn more about CSS logical properties, make sure to check out my video on CSS logical properties. All right, let's submit this challenge. And this is a 100% match, so this should be good enough. Let's move to our next challenge, and this is going to be our last challenge, 146 streaks. Here we need to create this interesting pattern, and this actually looks like a background pattern to me, and I'm thinking that the easiest way to recreate this would be to actually use repeating linear gradient property. I'll remove the comment first, and we don't even need this div here, we'll actually just use the body tag, and we'll set background to repeating linear gradient. And repeating linear gradient actually takes a number of values. And the first one is actually direction of the gradient. And this can be set as to bottom, to top left, or something like that. Or you could actually specify it in degrees. And that's exactly what I'm going to do here because this looks to me like it's set at 45 degrees. So I'll try that first, 45 degrees. And now we need to actually create a gradient that is going to be repeated. The first color we have in our gradient is going to be this green one. So I'll copy that and I'll paste it here. I set its position to 0 pixels. So this is going to be our first stop in our repeating linear gradient. And our second stop is going to be at something like 20 pixels because this looks like it's 20 pixels wide. So what's happening here is we're actually repeating the green color endlessly until it fills the entirety of our element. So we'll need our second color, and our second color is going to be this yellow one. So I'll set this, and this color will start exactly at 20 pixels and it will go until 40 pixels. That way we'll have exactly the stripe that we want. All right, let's see how this works. And obviously this is not a correct angle that I want. I actually want angle minus 45 degrees. And stripes look like they're not big enough, so I probably need 25 pixels instead of 20. 25, and this is going to be 50. Now this looks better. But as you can see, we actually want our first stop to be this black and not the yellow one. Green is okay, so I'll change this. This is going to be our black. And our next stop is going to be yellow. And this is going to start at 50 pixels. And it will spread for another 25 pixels, which means it's going to stop at 75 pixels. And this looks exactly like the gradient we have, but this gradient is actually repeating until it fills the entirety of the screen. We actually just want to repeat it twice. So we would either need to change the size of this element somehow to cut off unnecessary stripes, or we can manually specify colors to be repeated twice and then fill the rest of the background with the solid green color that we have here. So I'll copy my stripes here, paste them and tweak the positioning. So this is going to start at 75 pixels and it's going to spread to 100. This is going to start at 100 and it's going to go until 125. And the last one is going to start at 125 pixels and it's going to spread until 150 pixels. And now we actually have those first two stripes created, but again, they're repeating, so we still see entirety of our background filled, which means that the last thing that we need to do is we need to specify green color to fill the rest of our available space. So this green will start at 150 pixels and is going to spread until 100% or rest of the page. And this looks exactly like the target we have here. So what we did here is we created repeating linear gradient and we specify color stops exactly at the point where we want the stripes to appear. We're specifying green color that starts at 0 pixels, that's spreading to 25 pixels. And this is a solid color because we have the same color specified at the different stops. And since those stripes are 25 pixels big, we're actually specifying those color stops at 25 pixels, or rather 25, 50, 75, and so on. We are repeating those stripes twice, and the rest of the body is filled with a solid green color again, which starts from 150 pixels, which is going to be here, and goes all the way to the 100% of the element, which is going to be somewhere here at the end. All right, I'll submit this challenge. And again, it's a 100% match, which means that we created exactly what we needed. And this streaks challenge is actually the last one that's available. The rest of the challenges are still locked. So hopefully this shows you how interesting this CSS battle project is and how it can challenge you to actually explore different solutions or creative solutions to some maybe common or uncommon problems that you might face in your day-to-day work. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Nyambor. I will see and hear you in the next CSS battle, or rather in the next video. And until then, hit that subscribe button and please share your result for this particular challenge in the comments, because I really like to see how well you did. Or if you have a better solution that I explored, please share that in comments as well.